Hi, I'm Russell with the Hacksmith, and we are here at the Ontario Science Centre Challenge Zone. Today we're going to talk about the cool science of electromagnetism. Let's take a minute to talk about that.
All right, let's get started.
Yeah.
Hey guys, I'm the Hacksmith, and on our YouTube channel we take fictional ideas from comics, movies, and video games and make real working prototypes. Last year we made Captain America's iconic shield, complete with an electromagnet bracer that allows us to attract it from short distances.
Now movies tend to take science for granted, so let's talk a little bit about electromagnetism and why Captain America's shield cannot be attracted from great distances just like we see in the movies.
So electromagnetism is one of the four fundamental forces of physics. That's gravitational, electromagnetic, strong nuclear, and weak nuclear. Electromagnetism is just like electrostatic, but with flowing electrons instead of static charges. Basically, flowing electrons, or electric current, causes an imbalance of charges, resulting in a magnetic field.
If you pass a current through a copper wire, you create a magnetic field around the wire. If you coil up the wire, then you increase that magnetic field. By placing an iron core within the coil, you channel the magnetic field and create an electromagnet.
Now, the strength of the electromagnet varies on two things, the amount of coils or the amount of current running through them. Put simply, the more coils or more current equals a much stronger field. Unfortunately, the strength of that magnetic field decreases proportional to the inverse square of the distance. So while I might have 10,000 newtons of lifting force at the electromagnet, at a distance of 1 meter, Russell can't even feel it. But if I bring it in close, he's not getting it up. Now, if we wanted to attract the shield from the same distances as shown in the movie, we'd quite literally need Tony Stark's arc reactor to power the thing, which can hypothetically produce over 3,000 megawatts of electricity.
Now, of course, that kind of power would melt the magnet.
To learn more awesome stuff, check out the other 60 seconds of science videos by clicking on the links in the description below.
Or come to the Ontario Science Centre. Anyway, thank you very much for watching, and may the forces be with you.